Scientists, cosmologists, astronomers, and more have been watching the stars for centuries now, trying to uncover their secrets. But for all we have realized about the true nature of the universe, there's still so much that we haven't. There's still an endless stream of cosmic information that we don't yet know or haven't yet proven. For instance, while we do of course know that other planets exist, we've so far only proven them to exist beyond doubt within the Milky Way. But that could be about to change. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, did scientists just finally discover a planet beyond our galaxy? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. Whenever we speak of planets that aren't Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, or Neptune, that is, planets that are outside the solar system, we refer to them as exoplanets. And for a long time, scientists have been confident that the universe should be full of exoplanets. Some predictions claim that almost all stars should have at least one orbiting around them, while others say there should be lots of stars hosting more than one planet, like our own sun does. In either case, while the estimates do vary, it's thought that there could be trillions of planets in the Milky Way alone. And considering the highest estimates reckon at 2 trillion or more galaxies in the universe, we're potentially talking trillions of planets out there in total. It's perhaps surprising then that we've officially cataloged only a few thousand of them so far. As of 2021, there are still less than 5,000 exoplanets officially confirmed by science and observation. And all the ones that have been recorded can be found comfortably within our own galaxy, the Milky Way. The first was in 1992, when the exoplanets known as Phobator and Poltergeist were discovered orbiting around a pulsar known as PSR B1257+12, around 2,300 light-years away from us. More than 2,500 of the other exoplanets we know about so far were detected by the groundbreaking Kepler Space Telescope over an almost 10-year mission run by NASA between 2009 and 2018. In general, scientists expect the number of known exoplanets to sharply rise over the coming years, however, especially following the launches of missions like the James Webb Space Telescope led by NASA, the Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope also by NASA, and the Plato Space Telescope by the European Space Agency, which are all scheduled over the next decade. When it comes to the universe, we're expanding our horizons faster and more efficiently than ever before. Which brings us to the key discovery for today's video. In late October 2021, news broke of a potential sighting of an exoplanet not in the Milky Way, and literally millions of light-years further away from us than anything else we've ever found. The discovery was made through a study by a team at the Center for Astrophysics, a joint venture by Harvard University and the Smithsonian, with scientists using data from NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory, an X-ray space telescope that's been running since launch in 1999. And indeed, the X-ray capabilities of Chandra are crucial to this story. Typically, when astronomers search for new planets, the detecting of transits is one of the best and most reliable ways of finding what they need. A transit is when a planet moves between its host star and the observer, which is us here on Earth. When this happens, we can measure a slight dimming in the brightness of the host star, a change in the optical light that's coming from it, thereby confirming that a planet has passed between us and it, and therefore confirming that, yes, a planet does exist there. When astronomers gaze through their telescopes searching for exoplanets, then, they're not really looking for the planets themselves, but rather the distinct effect any planet can have on the star that it's closest to. The problem is that this doesn't and will likely never work when looking out at greater distances than just a few thousand light-years. The dimming of a star's optical light during a regular transit can only ever carry so far through space, which means that we can't expect to employ quite the same method when searching for planets that are not in the Milky Way, at distances hundreds of thousands of light-years away from us or more. It's a different story with X-ray emissions, though, and here's where the Chandra Observatory comes in. Chandra is designed to detect X-ray sources in the universe. That is, non-optical light with a high frequency and short wavelength. It has to be a space-based telescope orbiting the Earth because X-rays are generally lost within our planet's atmosphere, meaning that ground-based telescopes just cannot pick them up. It's also why the data that passes through Chandra offers astronomers something different to analyze, though, painting the universe as it does in literally a different light. And the crucial thing here is that X-ray transits, that is, the disruption of an X-ray emission caused by a passing planet, are theoretically possible to capture at far greater distances away from Earth. Extragalactic distances, even. Which is what scientists in this case are claiming that Chandra has managed to do. The study, published in October 2021 by the Center for Astrophysics, focused in on the spiral galaxy Messier 51, also known as M51 or the Whirlpool Galaxy. M51 is thought to be around 76,000 light-years in diameter, but also about 28 million light-years away from us. Inside M51, however, scientists know of a specific binary system, catchily named M51-ULS1. And it's inside this system where our potential first exoplanet detected outside the Milky Way resides. It's thought that the binary at the center of the system is made up of two things, a massive star and either a neutron star or a black hole. And it's the dramatic interactions that occur between these huge cosmic structures which then produce the X-ray emissions that the Chandra Observatory can register in the first place. The really interesting part came, however, when scientists noticed that during a moment when Chandra was focused on M51-ULS1 specifically, there unfolded a period of around 3 hours when the X-rays coming out of it dimmed, and for a short time even disappeared. This means that something was blocking them, and the suggestion is that that something is a planet. Researchers crunched the numbers and, according to a report on the Center for Astrophysics website, estimate that the proposed planet should be about the same size as Saturn, and it should orbit its binary host at about double the distance that our Saturn does from our star, the Sun. The bad news here is that if those calculations ring true, then it'll be another 70 years or so before the same planet will transit again between us and its X-ray heart. This means that scientists will not be able to definitely confirm what they saw until that time, or such time as we develop a new, non-transit but equally reliable way of detecting far-off planets. And of course, it is possible that the X-ray dimming that was measured from M51-ULS-1 could have been caused by something else, a passing gas or dust cloud perhaps, although the scientists behind the study have said that they think this to be unlikely. Up until this apparent breakthrough, most of all confirmed exoplanets have fallen within a range of around 3,000 light-years from Earth. At this distance, it's much more possible to measure potential transits via optical light. But now, thanks to alternative X-ray tactics, the astronomical landscape may have changed forever, and the search for new planets may have slipped into overdrive. If what scientists have detected inside the M51 galaxy is a planet, then it's a few million times farther away from us than most other planets we've ever encountered. Science has predicted for a long time that planets like this should be out there and in huge numbers, but now we're beginning to really see them. So how should this story make us feel? It's perhaps a little daunting whenever we try to contemplate the true scale of the universe. For the modern human, the idea of just Mars or Venus can seem alien enough, and they're the closest possible other planets to us. Consider then the incomparably vast expanse that exists between us and the M51, and all the possibilities that could play out in space from here to there. It's incredible to think about, but it's also exciting. For so long, we've looked up to the sky with wonder, but gradually, we're coming to terms with it. And that's how scientists may have just discovered a planet beyond our galaxy. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.